Namespaces are like containers for classes. Their purpose is to help you organize your scripts and to avoid conflicts between scripts. You might, for example, be making tools in Unity to help you develop your application. You could keep the tools and actual application in separate namespaces, so you didn't have too many unnecessary classes being suggested by autocomplete. Chances are, all of the scripts you have been writing so far have been using namespaces. At the top of C# scripts in Unity, by default, you'll see two lines: using Unity Engine, and using System.Collections. Unity Engine and System.Collections are both namespaces. The using keyword means that anything within the namespace that follows can be used in the script. Try commenting out the using directives at the top of the script, and you can see that autocomplete has far fewer classes that you can use. That's because classes like GameObject, Transform, RigidBody, and many more are all in the Unity Engine namespace. In order to put our class in a namespace, we need to surround the class with the namespace syntax. Start off with the keyword namespace, and then the namespace's name. This can be an existing namespace or a new one. In this case, we are going to call our namespace sample namespace. Then we have an open brace before the class and a close brace after the class. Since our class now belongs to sample namespace, we'll indent it to show belonging. There are three ways we can use the classes from a specific namespace. We've already seen the first, which is to include a using directive at the top of your script. The second way to access the class is to use the dot operator. For example, instead of having using sample namespace at the top of the script, every time we wanted to reference a class from the sample namespace, we could type sample namespace dot and then the class. This option avoids ambiguity, but can be cumbersome, particularly with large namespace names like sample namespace. The last option is to put the class that you are writing into the namespace that you need access to. This is generally not recommended, unless you mean to have that class in the same namespace anyway. So long as classes are in different namespaces, they may have the same name. However, since scripts have the same name as the class contained in them, the scripts must be in different folders in order to have the same class name. When using namespaces, be careful to avoid ambiguous definitions. For example, two very common namespaces to use are System and Unity Engine. These both contain a definition for a class called random. If you are using them both, you need to disambiguate the class by using the dot operator. Either use system.random or unityengine.random. You might have noticed that the second default using directive is the system.collections namespace. This illustrates that namespaces are nestable. In order to nest namespaces, simply enclose one namespace declaration within another.